Welcome to my home. I'm glad your journey led you to my doorstep. Please, do not hesitate to step inside. There is no need for you to tell me your name, your age, or your place of birth. It does not matter what language you speak. It does not matter what you do for a living. It does not matter what educational attainment you have. It does not matter how wealthy you are. It does not matter what clothes you wear. It does not matter which God you worship. Don't be concerned that the appearance of my skin may be a shade or two different from yours. It is absolutely sufficient for the two of us to look at each other's eyes just for a second. It is necessary to allow soul, both yours and mine, to greet each other. In that very moment we'll know whether we are meeting for the first time or we became close to each other way back, so much so that we have no recollection of it, while feeling our souls still painfully longing for each other. Now being inside, I leave the front door ajar and I'll move out of your sight. I would like to give you an opportunity to view my artwork alone, the tangible symbols of my spiritual growth and of my life journey. I hope at least some of them will grab your attention and gently touch the strings of your heart. Maybe you'll find one part of yourself in some of my sculptures. Maybe some images, shapes, or colors from my paintings will awaken your memories that, as if on a hidden boat, have come floating to the shore of your dreams. Maybe some of my art pieces will look provocative and will prompt you to either quickly turn away from them or, in astonishment, come closer. If you felt that on your journey you stepped into a wrong home, make an exit quietly. Don't worry, you don't have to say goodbye. I'll understand. I won't be hurt. My door is always open for you in case you decide to return. If you would like to share your impressions with me, please wait until I join you. We'll choose a spot where both of us feel comfortable and safe in each other's presence. We will then sit down and once again look at each other's eyes. This time, we'll do it for quite a while with no words spoken. You might be surprised when you see me sitting on the floor with my legs crossed. I hope you will not object to it. That's when I feel the best. In that position, my body is in complete alignment with my soul. It is then where both my past and present feelings reach their culmination. It is then that I transform into love, into longing, into pain, into anguish, into sorrow, into despair, into happiness, into tears, into laughter. It is then that I become the tree and the flower, the desert and the hill, the sun and the rain, the cloud and the sky, the storm and the snow. When I'm standing up, I'm standing with pride. I know who I am. Where needed, I'm both the mother and the father, the woman and the man, the friend and the mate, the sister and the brother, the teacher and the student. I have wisdom, knowledge, courage and ability to achieve that for which I was told by many is impossible. On those words, I just gently smile and say, watch me. I consider it to be my responsibility to protect the innocent and heal the wounded. Thanks for paying me a visit. Say hello to your friends for me. When you meet a new person, don't forget to be kind. You never know what pain they're hiding deep in their soul.